paper that gave us headlines like this: why I stuck a cracker up my clacker. The Northern Territory News follows the weird stories from the public, plus unexpected in local politics. Let's welcome NT News Deputy Editor Ben Smee to studio. I've got to say, this paper is a national treasure. I think it is such a fantastic rag. Let's start with the crazy times up there leading up to the last election. We have this front page, Night of the Long Knives. It's about a leadership coup that failed when the target refused to stand aside. Then we have some of this, Get On With It or Get Out. Again, the NT News telling it straight to political leaders. Polysex scandal, far too much exposure for minister. And bloodbath, when the government crashed and the governing party was almost annihilated. That's the thing with the NT News. I think it's it has these crazy headlines sometimes, but it's actually a very, very good paper that follows the news very, very well. It has a wonderful audience.
Yeah, we like to be. I mean, we've put a lot of effort into our political coverage over the last few years, and we've been blessed with a script that the writers from Game of Thrones probably couldn't have come up with themselves. So it's been fun. Mm.
Now, after that clacker headline, and I'm all for clackers, and clearly the NT News is as well, why do you love the clacker?
I don't know about the clacker, but it's the cracker that he shoved up the clacker that I think was real interesting.
Because there was the cracker up the clacker and then a packer up my clacker.
Yes.
There's been a lot of clackers.
Yeah, I just, you know, we...
That was so good, that headline.
Yeah, I think these won Walkley Awards, didn't they?
The why I stuck a cracker up my clacker was part of a Walkley Award-winning headline entry. Paul Dyer, our former deputy editor, won a Walkley for those headlines. Mm. Just, you know, crazy stuff that goes on in the NT. Highlight in a unique way.
Mm-hmm. How on earth did someone get bashed with a prawn?
my understanding is it was a frozen block of prawns that a midnight fridge raider in Darwin, everyone has an outdoor fridge that they keep their beer and their prawns and everything else in, and apparently a bloke got disturbed by a midnight fridge raider and who grabbed a block of frozen prawns and clocked him with it.
Which could be very painful.
Absolutely. Good.
Crocodiles often star on your front page, which is fantastic. Yep. What are some of the highlights with the crocodiles? It's real. Yep. That is scary.
It is real. And every time we do a front page like that, people often...
It's biting a shark.
Yep. People always question whether those photos are actually real, and particularly that one, G'day Bait, where the fellow was basically having to run from an aggressive croc. I mean, they're such great fodder for us. They give us so many good stories and good headlines.
Do you have the crocodiles on a retainer?
we've often joked of that we do need a crocodile correspondent, someone out there sort of trawling the rivers trying to come up with stories for us.
But speaking of which, how on earth do they come up with these lines? Like, do you have a competition in the office, the most outrageous? And does it have to actually relate to the story?
They do have to relate to the story, but it's a pretty fun process in the newsroom trying to come up with some of these.
Do you have a competition?
Oh
my goodness.
That's terrifying.
Do you have a competition of who can come up with the best and then a leaderboard of who's got the most outrageous?
There usually is. There's a few people who are pretty exceptional. Paul Dyer, who won the Walkley, Julian Ritchie, Rachel Hancock and Matt Williams, their editors, who always sort of coming up with ideas, and it's usually a sort of collaborative process coming up with some of those headlines.
Mm. I remember, was it the day that Malcolm Turnbull became Prime Minister? I think the headline was his tiny little box down the bottom, rich dude becomes PM.
That's right.
Was that right? What was the main story?
Well, the main story, actually, there was a really horrific domestic violence in the Territory.
Yes.
And we sort of thought, well, you know, who cares what's going on in Canberra? And we sort of took that flippant approach with the main headline about the leadership coup in Canberra. But we feel so disconnected from all of that sort of stuff up in the Territory, and we felt that it was kind of important that we didn't bury that story somewhere further back, that we made a bit of a point with it too, and that's one of the great things that we can do.
And I must say, you know, for all of the cheeky headlines that you have done some really inspirational reporting, particularly on the domestic violence crisis in the Northern Territory. Aboriginal women are 35 times more likely to be victims of domestic violence. It's a really important story that you guys are covering.
Yeah, absolutely. And, you know, we do pride ourselves on that, and a lot of our issues coverage. You know, we fight for the interests of our readers, like any good local newspaper or regional newspaper. And you know, people often see the headlines, and they're great, and we love them, and we love having a bit of fun with them. But we're also really proud of a lot of the other coverage we do too.
I think you're one of the few newspapers that's actually growing in circulation, aren't you?
I think so. I think our you know, readership is doing pretty well. I think we recently ticked over 300,000 Facebook likes, which is more than the population of the Northern Territory.
Yeah, right.
so it obviously shows there's a real appeal about what we're doing.
It is a national treasure, that's for sure. And the book by Ben Smee and Christopher Walsh, it is called Crocs in the Cabinet. Ben, thanks so much for coming and chatting with us today.
Thank you.